If you look back historically at heat engines, the drawbacks of heat engines are they're really big and heavy for how much power they produce. They're not very efficient because it's hard to transfer heat efficiently across metal boundaries. And they didn't really work in direct drive applications, meaning if you think about having a crankshaft, as an example, connected to an old school heat engine, the transient response wouldn't be very good, so they would be sluggish, they would be heavy, and they would be not very efficient. What we've done is we've taken that same heat engine concept. We've reinvented sort of the way that it's done, sort of kind of repackaged the thermodynamics, redesigned from a mechanical perspective, sort of from ground zero. And so now we have something that is more power dense than its competitors and that is more fuel efficient because we're able to transfer heat at rates that have never been seen before and completely eliminated the mechanical output. So all three things that held heat engines back in the past, we have solved. And so the time is right for these to sort of take over as the new generation of ultra efficient, high power dense, durable systems.
One of the benefits is you're starting from a thermodynamic cycle that inherently has a better inherent thermodynamic efficiency than like a regular auto or diesel cycle. So that's a huge benefit. And then the external combustion, how it makes us truly fuel flexible. Those two things come to mind in terms of the overall technology. You know, it's a great selling point. And then being part of the transition, you know, as the infrastructure changes, it's able to flex with the infrastructure. Today, hydrogen is not readily available everywhere. Whenever hydrogen becomes a thing, we can flex to that, so it gives the technology the longevity in the future as well.